I'm Ranger Ariel, and I'm here at Staunton River State Park, and I'm excited to talk to all of you about one of my favorite topics, bugs. So we are first going to start out with the June bug, and I've got one in here, so you all can see. This is a June bug. They get their name because they usually start emerging in big swarms in June. They are found all over North America, and during the day they like to hide in trees. But once early summer gets here, they like to fly around in big swarms, usually at night, but you can see them during the day as well. So these guys are super cute, and they typically eat on leaves, but when they're larvae, they feed on roots and plants when they're underground. And one fun fact is that when these guys are larvae, they can live underground for 2 to 3 years. So that is our very cute June bug. They don't cause any harm to us, so it's fine to pick them up. Just be gentle with them and try not to disturb them too much. Our next guy is one of my favorites. This is a very cute little caterpillar known as the Hallow Caterpillar. So here's this little guy. Again, he's very, very cute, and he is a Hallow Caterpillar. So these are found in North America, mostly on the East Coast, but they can be found as far west as Kansas and Texas, as far south as Florida, and as far north as Canada. So this little guy is a caterpillar. It has host trees, and that's what they eat on. So this one's host trees are oaks, peach, and willow trees. So they will feed on those leaves as a little caterpillar. So obviously this one's currently a caterpillar, but they have a large life cycle. So this one was probably recently hatched from an egg. Now it's in the caterpillar phase. And then next, it'll pupate, and then it'll become a moth. So I will show you what they look like. Once that guy's done being a caterpillar, it'll look like this. This is the Hallow moth. So that's what it looks like as an adult. It's a pretty common garden moth. This is it with its wings spread. These are often found in gardens because as adults, they actually feed on nectar. So they're a pollinating moth. And a lot of people don't know that. Not just butterflies pollinate, some moths do as well. And a fun fact about these guys is that they are active during the day and night. They're still attracted to light, but they're not afraid to come out in the sunshine and feed on some flowers. We got someone trying to escape here. Our next topic is earthworms. Here's a whole handful of worms for you. That one's going crazy. So these guys live wherever there is food, moisture, and oxygen. They like to live underground. They eat on organic matter when they're underground living, and when they're above ground, they sometimes feed on leaves. So these guys don't have any arms. They don't have any legs, and they also don't have any eyes. So some fun facts about these guys. In 1 acre of land, there can be over 1 million earthworms. That's pretty wild. And also, they can eat their weight in food every day. These guys can really eat. Oh, we got one. I don't have a live version, but I do have a little exoskeleton shell of a cicada. So cicadas are actually really, really cool. You probably see these around your yard. It's just the exoskeleton. So this is an exoskeleton of a nymph cicada, and I'll tell you all about that. So cicadas actually start out as rice-shaped eggs. They're very small little eggs, and then they emerge and they are nymphs. And at this point, they feed on juices that are in trees. And then as they get older and they're ready, they go ahead and drop down from their tree. They go to the ground, and then they tunnel until they find roots that they can eat and feed on. And then they'll stay underground between 2 to 17 years, depending on which type of cicada there is. Now, while they're down there for all those years, they are not hibernating. They are actively tunneling and eating on roots and things like that. So once they're ready, they emerge from the ground and they find the closest tree they can find, they get on there and they shed their nymph exoskeleton. And that is what you often find in your yard. Once they do that, their adult bodies, their wings start to emerge with fluid and their bodies start to harden. And then they're ready to begin their adult life. Unfortunately, their adult life is pretty brief. They mostly spend their time trying to find a mate, mating, and then laying eggs. So most of their life is actually spent underground while they're a nymph. So some fun facts, they actually do really good stuff for our soil. So they're not really pests. They dig around in our soil and they move that soil around and aerate it. So it's actually really good for us and our soil. So the next brood that is coming is brood 9. It's emerging this year in 2020 in West Virginia, Virginia, and North Carolina. So we should be seeing lots of cicadas soon. So those cicadas are periodic. So they emerge every 13 to 17 years. There are also annual cicadas that emerge every year. So our last group that we're gonna talk about, they are pillbugs. You can kind of see them. So these are also known as roly-polies. You can see this one's rolled up because it feels threatened, but there's one over here that's not rolled up. There's one there as well. So although this is bugging out and we're talking all about bugs, these guys actually aren't bugs. Even though they're called pillbugs, they're actually crustaceans. So even though I have them here grouped with all these other bugs and insects, they're actually more closely related to shrimp and crayfish. And that's because they have a hard exoskeleton. They also breathe through gills, and they have to live somewhere that's moist. So mostly you can find them under rocks. That's where I found these guys today. I just looked under a rock and they were living down there. While they're down there, they mostly eat rotten vegetation, like vegetables and things like that. And they're actually the only crustacean that spend all of their life on land. And if they dry out, they'll die. So I'm gonna put these guys back under a rock very shortly. So these are just a few little creatures that we have here at the park. There are tons more, but that's all we have time for today. But if you feel like it, go out in your yard and kind of look for some cool creepy crawlies and check them out. Thank you.